Hey everyone, Michelle Jackson here, lead pastor of Hope Christian Church. I am so glad that you're here and a part of our Love Challenge. God is doing amazing things in the life of our church, and we're so grateful that you're able to be a part of these devotional times with us. So lately, we've been talking about finding contentment in God, the necessity of knowing that our life is not dependent on the happenings to have happiness, but we can have joy unspeakable and full of glory by finding contentment in the Lord. So today I wanted to go back to Colossians chapter 3, which is a powerful passage of scripture that I encourage you to read. And I wanted to talk to you from verse 14 today, and 14 and 15, in expanding this theme around peace. And it reads, Colossians chapter 3, verse 14 and 15 says, "Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony or unity. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts. For as members of one body, you are called to live in peace. Always be thankful." So two things I wanted to highlight to you today from these two verses that are powerful and life-changing. Number one, we are called to live in peace, and that peace should be an umpire in our heart. Our hearts are the seat of our mind, will, and emotions, right? And so out of our heart flow the issues of life. So when we're not at peace, out of the abundance of the heart or the lack of peace, our mouth begins to speak. And so it's so important that we let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding and mounts a garrison or protects our heart and mind in Christ Jesus, that we allow ourselves to live from that peace and let that peace be the connection with others in the body of Christ, right? So many times we can come into relationships or friendships based on misery, you know, because misery loves company, or based on hurts of the past or pains that we've been through or shared struggles. And all of those are okay connections. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that those people are not great friends or even encouragement or support in your life. But what I'm telling you is that and sharing with you today is that the higher quality connection with others and even in the body of Christ is that peace, the peace of God, becomes our connection and allows us to flow in harmony and unity, everybody playing their part and expressing their gift that God's placed inside of them for us to be a fully expressive body, every part playing its function through the peace of God. And at this peace, we're called to live in it. We're called to dwell in it. We're called to abide in the peace of God, the peace, the shalom of God, where there's abundance of provision, where there's nothing missing, where there's nothing broken. And this peace is to bind us together in unity, but it's also to be a habitation for us. And so many times we like our happiness are thinking that peace is circumstantial. I'll have peace when all my kids are behaving. I'll have peace when I get that promotion, or I'll have peace when I have this certain amount of money, or I'll have peace when I move to a certain neighborhood. But the peace that God gives is a spiritual peace, and it's important that we learn how to live in it, abide in it, stay in it. And one of the second thing I wanted to share with you is the add-on of verse 15. And it says, "And always be thankful." Gratitude is a spiritual weapon. Gratitude is a spiritual weapon. When we're talking about these issues of the soul, the mind, the will, the emotions, these areas of our heart, we really have to remember that gratitude is a spiritual weapon. The enemy will always try to make us feel either that we're not what God has created us to be, identity, or that we can't have what God has said we can have, because he comes. John 10:10 tells us that he comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And so he's always trying to push us down and make us feel less than, or that we don't have, or that we're not, because he wants to encroach upon and take what does not belong to him. But I came to encourage you today and to stir you up to recognize that gratitude, what you have, who you are, is so valuable. Jesus for the joy that was set before him went to the cross. He endured the cross and he purchased you. He was a ransom for all of us, for the soul of humanity to break the power of sin and death. So whether you have the material trappings that say you are successful or not, is not the point of what the enemy's trying to steal from you. He's trying to steal the God potential in you and have you abort the mission that God has called you to in this season. So we've got to activate the mentality of being thankful at all times, prayerful at all times. But gratitude is this spiritual weapon that we need to exercise, and it will cause us to be able to live in this place of peace. So it's so important. It's so important that we wear the love of God as a garment, that we clothe ourselves in the agape love of God, that we learn how to love our lives and love others with the vision and the unconditional love of God that sees potential even when there are problems. I'm not saying that there's not a need for boundaries. I'm not saying in relationships, right? I'm not saying that there's not a need to have appropriate cautions. But what I am saying is that for God so loved the world that he sent his son. And so we have to make sure that we're clothing ourselves in a love that sees that every sinner has a potential and a possibility to become a saint. And that all of us remember that we were once yet sinners, but yet God loved us in the middle of our mess and sent his son, and that someone introduced us to the love of God. And so we have to clothe ourselves in that way that allows us to come into a unity as the body, and that the peace of God is the connection. And then from there, that we utilize gratitude for what God has done, how far he's brought us from, and what he continues to do, his keeping power, that we allow that to be a weapon in this time for us. One of the biggest things that the enemy has tried to do in this season, and I know as soon as I say it, you're going to say, yeah, I've seen that, is to bring division within the church over ideologies and thoughts and stances on issues, but also bring division between us and the world. Well, the division between us and the world should happen so that the true sons of God can be revealed. That's a great division that needs to happen. The shaking does need to reveal those things, as Hebrews 12 tells us, that belong to the kingdom. But I want you to be mindful of the divisions within the church, right? Because there are some that are with us that are not of us. But those that are, we don't want to be divided. We don't want to have a body that can't come together and be effectual in this time. We want to make sure that the peace of God allows us to work together in unity, and that we're able to, as the whole body at Hope Christian Church and the Church Universal, to be able to accomplish what God has sent us to do, so that we are fully functional in our gifting, but also in our position of authority that God has given us. And so peace is going to allow us to be able to do that, the peace that comes from God. So I just want to encourage you in this time to check where you are, check the battle lines, make sure that the battle lines that you've drawn in this season are accurate, and that you can live in peace with all men, and also live in peace as a member of the body of Christ. That you check your connection to the body of Christ today. Many of us have begun to worship from home. We're not as connected as we used to be to the household of faith. We connect through means like this that are not interactive. It's a one-way stream. I want you to check your connection and make sure that you have accountability in your life, that you're connected to a Bible-believing church. If you consider Hope Christian Church of your church home, I want you to make sure that you have some kind of interactive discipleship relationship with this church. We do that through classes, through small groups, through other mechanisms, and we send these kinds of videos out in our services on streams to be of an encouragement and a supplement, but not the primary connection. So I want you to make sure that whether you're coming to services physically or not, that you have a strong connection to the household of faith. And remember, gratitude is a spiritual weapon that we can use in this time so that we don't allow the enemy to take anything that he does not, that does not belong to him, because that's what he does. And trust me, he's on his job in this time like never before. All right, so we're going to pray together. Father, I thank you, Lord, just for peace in this time. Lord, help us to learn how to clothe ourselves in love, the love that sent you to Calvary, the love that sent you to be the ransom for all of our sin, to break the curse of death, to break the curse of sin from humanity. Lord, we thank you that we are first partakers of that love that we give and bestow to our families, to our neighbors, to our friends, our community, and above all to the household of faith. So Lord, we thank you that we will learn how to live in peace in this time, live in your shalom, live in your abundance, live in a place where your peace is a protection for us against the worries of this world, but also the things that would try to come in like moth to eat and rust, that would seek to destroy the things that you purpose for us to have that are intangible, that are eternal. And Lord, we thank you that we'll be wise as serpents in this season and harmless as doves, that we'll begin to see where the enemy would seek to come in and steal from us, seek to come in and steal peace, seek to come in and steal joy, so that we can guard our hearts with all diligence, knowing that you are the one who's keeping us in this time. So Father, we thank you for what you're doing in and through us and in and through our church. We give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Listen, if you were convicted by just my encouragement of being connected to the church, you can go to your app store, either on Google Play or the app store if you're an Apple user, and download our Hope Christian Church app. It's Hope Christian Church MD. And once you download the app, it's free. You'll see all the upcoming events and different interactive ways that you can get connected to the church. I just strongly encourage you in this time to get rooted, get grounded, and get growing in Jesus' name. All right. I'd love to hear from you. If you want to send me an email about how God is blessing you or how you've been touched by this ministry or how we can be of service to you, how we can help you in this time, I'd love to hear from you. You can email me at info@thehopeconnection.org, info@thehopeconnection.org, and I look forward to hearing from you. So I'll see you here next time in our Love Challenge. Be blessed.